Hello, I'm a Baggy Hi-Fi subscriber, and I haven't left the house in 5 years.
Greetings, pop pickers. Welcome to Baggy Hi-Fi, this YouTube channel devoted to record collecting and the vinyl community here in the UK. Well, recently Steve Carlson made a video about how someone had given him some free records. And if you're watching this, you probably are a record collector and you've had this experience where people find out that you collect vinyl. And so, I suppose, kindly they offer to offload their old records in the garage that they don't want. Very often, as Steve Carlson found out, there's a load of rubbish and you can maybe pick out one or two decent records from the pile. Well, this is what I'm going to talk about in this video. An acquaintance heard that I collect records, and instead of just giving me the whole bunch of records, she typed up a list of albums and singles. Now, the album list had a couple of interesting records that I thought, ooh, you know, these apparently from her husband, who mainly collected records in the early 70s. There was Master of Reality by Black Sabbath and also Machine Head by Deep Purple. And I thought, these could be, you know, first pressings maybe, or second pressings. You know, there might be a Vertigo swirl in there. Anyway, when I got the list of albums, I had most of the others, but I didn't have those two. And I was told that by the lady who was giving them away, that she, her daughter had claimed the Black Sabbath and the Deep Purple albums. So there was nothing in the list of LPs that I wanted. But the list of singles was different. I mean, there weren't any amazing records on there, but some I definitely wanted. So I took a picture and WhatsApped her and said which ones I wanted. So that's what this video is. All from the early 70s, quite a time of mixed and varied music. There was glam emerging. There was previously underground artists like T-Rex becoming commercial. There was still a lot of novelty records around, and there were records by the Kinks and in the early 70s heyday. So nothing ultra rare. They're not in amazing condition, but they're certainly all in VG Plus condition, definitely playable. Now I've cleaned them up. So this video, I am going to show you this batch of singles, which I got free. Here is the first batch, and this is the most proggy single out of the lot. I Know What I Like in Your Wardrobe by Genesis, of course, from Selling England by the Pound, 1973. Quite happy to have this because of the B-side, Twilight Alehouse, which I don't think is on any of their official albums. Next one on the Rack label, Tom Tom Turnaround by a band called New World. I think New World, I might be wrong, maybe one on some talent show like Opportunity Knocks. But what's interesting is that the songs were written by Chin Chapman, the writing team who wrote many glam classics like Super Susie Quattro and The Sweet. Next one on the nice RCA label, Clodagh Rodgers. She was an Irish singer. I think she was kind of set to be a rival to Cilla Black in the 70s, I suppose. Red hair. Lady Lovebug. I think, if I remember this one rightly, it's a bit of a sort of a Northern Soul type tune. But the B-side, something very different. Stand By Your Man, the Tammy Wynette song. I haven't played that one yet. That's from 1971. On the Fly label next, 1971 too, Tokoloshe Man by John Congos. I think this was a one-hit wonder, and it was sampled by Happy Mondays, I believe, in the 90s, for Step On. Now, this is very much a 70s single label, the Bell label. I think David Cassidy was on this one. Bay City Rollers, Keep On Dancing from 1971. What's on the B-side of this one? All Right. Ah, now you're talking. Street Life from the amazing album Stranded by Roxy Music, of course. B-side is Hula Kula, which I think could be an instrumental. I'll find out when I play it. Not on one of their official albums. Told you there was a bit of glam coming in here. Angel Fingers by Roy Wood, Roy Wood's Wizard. It says vocal backing by the Suedettes and the Bleach Boys. That's from 1973. Bit of a novelty record for the Straubs now. Not typical of their output, their sort of folk prog output. Part of the Union by Straubs. You don't get me, I'm part of the Union. Next one on the lovely DRAM label, When You Are a King, White Plains. If I remember this one rightly, this is also from 1971. Very nice melodic pop song. And now, Ardeen Taylor. There'll be a couple more Ardeen Taylor tracks later on. This is from 1974. Ardeen Taylor was one of the few white artists on Tamla Motown, but here he's on Polydor, and I don't know this one because it wasn't one of his famous ones. Now, another novelty record also on Polydor from 1971. Leap Up and Down, Wave Your Knickers in the Air by St. Cecilia. It says produced and directed by Jonathan King, a disgraced DJ and TV star from the 70s and 80s. Also the producer of Genesis's first album when they were still at Charterhouse Public School. I'm going to do an eardrop of that one because it has to be heard to be believed. Last one in this batch, The Lightning Tree by The Settlers. This was a theme song from a early 70s children's TV program called Follyfoot, which was, I think was aimed at young girls who like horses and horse riding and that kind of thing. Yeah, it's sounds like it was made by, you know, the King Singers, because it has that choral type singing on it, which is quite annoying. But it is, if you're old enough to remember Follyfoot, it's definitely a nostalgia trip. So I think we're going to have a couple of needle drops now. Ape Man by The Kinks, backed by Rats. I like that pie company sleeve. I mentioned that there were some more Ardeen Taylor tunes. This one is on Tamla Motown, 1966, but I think it was a hit much later on. There's a Ghost in My House, Northern Soul classic. And here's another one from 1971, not so much of a soul number. Indiana Wants Me, that nice brown Tamla Motown company sleeve. And here we are, and this is one I'm quite pleased with, 1971. One of the pre-blockbuster singles by The Sweet. I think this was a hit though, Alexander Graham Bell from 71. Now, talking about nice company sleeves, Parlophone, Cilla Black. Viewers, avid viewers of Baggy Hi-Fi will know that I am a fan of Cilla. This is Something Tells Me, Roger Cook and Greenaway tune. But on the other side, a song called La 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 Lu, and it's the theme song from the Please Sir movie. Now, Please Sir was a early 70s sitcom set in a working class secondary school starring John Alderton. And the film is worth watching. Well, I think it is anyway. And that's a very catchy theme song. Regal Zonophone label, the mover on this label for a while, you may know. This is The Banner Man by Blue Mink. Again, from 1971, this must have been the year that the owner of these records bought the most. Another bit of a novelty bubblegum tune, the Pushbike song by The Mixtures. Jug band type tune, a little bit like Mungo Jerry. Now, here's the only picture sleeve in the lot. Leapy Lee, Little Arrows, and this must have been bought in Germany, I think, because it's on the Hansa label, but Little Arrows by Leapy Lee. Now, this is an older one, on the Fontana record label, 1968, The Legend of Xanadu by Dave D, Dosey, Beaky, Mick and Titch. Classic with that whiplash sound effect in it. Now, this is the only other proggy item on the Atlantic label. Roundabout by Yes, 1972. B-side is Long Distance Runaround. I think this one looks like an ex-jukebox single. This is the only one with the Beatles connection. This is It Don't Come Easy by Ringo, produced by George Harrison. 1971 again on the Apple label. Now, here is a classic from 71, one of the finest singles produced by Tony Visconti in that year, Get It On by T-Rex. And finally, pleased with this one too, to have it, John Barry, theme from The Persuaders. Very synth heavy, very catchy tune, has a Cymbalon type melody going on, Eastern Europe type tune sound, which John Barry used in his Ipcress file soundtrack. But very nice to have theme from The Persuaders. What's on the other side? I haven't checked. Let's see. Oh yeah, The Girl with the Sun in Her Hair from You Only Live Twice.